So that morning, there was no question in my mind it was coming. And, you know, Chief Wolf and I, and at least our staffs, as a part of that, those meetings that we had, we did some fire scenarios with fire modeling.
Right.
And the fire model showed a fire just going right through town here. There's areas of town that, yeah, it's, wow. it would go through in a scenario like that when it's super hot, dry, and you've got 60, 70 mile an hour winds. There's really not much you can do.
And ash and things falling as well, right? And
right.
Burning debris probably.
Right, right.
Yeah.
The reason Estes didn't burn that day was because of a really rare fog. So the west side of the Continental Divide on the second day was still hot and dry. When we were talking to the people there, they were in t-shirts and the fire was still ripping.
Wow.
And mid-morning, we had a fog come up from the valley and the temperature dropped and that fog took the energy out of the fire. We didn't find out till later, till I flew the fire several days after the snow came.
Mm-hmm.
And we had, like that night or the previous night, we had over 3,000 to 4,000 acres of active crown fire on this side of the Continental Divide that we had no idea. And it was the combination of the fog and the smoke that no one could see.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, no one could see where the fire was. But when the decision to evacuate Estes came, it was midday, and that combination of smoke and fog created this eerie red glow in town. And I heard from several people that it was so eerie that they didn't question the evacuation at all. It was like, oh, yeah. This is apocalyptic.
It's
Let's
right
get
here.
Out of here. Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. But that fog stayed until 9 o'clock that night or so.
That was it. It just came up and stayed for a few hours and then.
Yeah. Yeah.
Incredible. That sounds almost divine intervention. Miraculous. That's incredible.
It was miraculous. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was,
wow.
It was
just
crazy.
What we needed.
And it's only happened, you know, it doesn't happen very often. You know, that night, I mean, we had so much fire on this side of the Continental Divide that if that fog didn't come, it was sitting there ready to be pushed by the wind.